Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Jacqueline Coley, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show. As I warn you, you're my last guest. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
Well, I'm so excited to talk about what Rotten Tomatoes knows or think we should know about this Sunday's Oscars. What do you know?
Well, one thing I will tell you is the Best Picture nominees is the highest average we've had in over a decade of Best Picture nominees. This is an incredible crop of award-worthy films. Films like Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, Jojo Rabbit, Marriage Story, 1917, and of course, the phenomenon that is Bong Joon-ho's Parasite.
That's incredible. So, at the end, I'm going to ask you, who do you think is going to win? But we'll move on. Okay, what other categories will we be listening to?
Well, it's kind of interesting this year. The Best Actor prizes, both in supporting and lead, are kind of a done deal if you sort of look at the indicating factors. Laura Dern for Best Supporting Actress, Brad Pitt for Best Supporting Actor, Joaquin Phoenix for Lead Actor, and Renee Zellweger for Lead Actress have all swept the major awards this year. So most people are betting on the four of them will also walk home with an Oscar on Sunday. But there are some really interesting storylines in the other categories. The screenplays, you have Quentin Tarantino going up against Bong Joon-ho for Best Original Screenplay. And then in adapted, you have Jojo Rabbit, the anti-hate satire from Taika Waititi, going up against Greta Gerwig's Little Women. All certified fresh films and films that I think a lot of people have a lot of investment in and want to root for.
Okay. Do we have any surprise nominations in any category?
As far as like any like maybe surprise wins, I think folks should pay attention to maybe the best song. Right now, Elton John is the lead in that category for his song for Rocket Man. He's hosted an Oscars award show for the better part of the last three decades that benefits AIDS charities. However, you know, Cynthia Erivo would become the youngest EGOT winner ever if she won for Harriet. So, you know, I wouldn't bet out on Cynthia. She might, you know, sort of shock the prognosticators.
That was my next question. You're so intuitive. You know, are there any young people? Because they usually indicate the next Hollywood star.
Well, right now, you know, for Little Women, you have Saoirse Ronan, who at barely, I think, maybe 25, is sort of an Oscars veteran from back when she was nominated first for Atonement. This is now, I think, going to be her fourth Oscar nomination. She was even nominated a couple of years ago, again with Greta Gerwig for Lady Bird. And then you have Florence Pugh. Again, both of them in the 95% certified fresh Little Women are younger actresses that I think are on their way to being these names that we're going to be hearing on the awards circuit for many, many years to come.
Okay, let's talk about any snubs. I love that category.
Yeah, I think everyone may join me in my chant of justice for J-Lo. You can't help but watch the Super Bowl on Sunday and lament the fact that she will not be with us at the Oscars this next Sunday. I think everyone, including J-Lo's people when they were prepping the awards, thought that would be the case. But unfortunately, she was not nominated for her work in the 87% certified fresh Hustlers. And it was a great, great performance.
Okay. Tell me, Netflix is the new kid on the block to watch. What's going on with them?
Can you say that again? I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Netflix.
Oh, yes.
What are they doing?
Yeah, I mean, Netflix has three films in the conversation this year, all with multiple nominations. Two Popes, which has two actor performances at the center from Anthony Hopkins and Jonathan Pryce. It also got adapted screenplay. But the two big sort of, I would say, films that they've been pushing this season are Martin Scorsese's Marriage Story and Noah Baumbach's, Martin Scorsese's The Irishman and Noah Baumbach's Marriage Story. I do think that, obviously, Noah Baumbach is going to walk away with the Best Supporting Actress win for Laura Dern. Again, she swept all the categories. However, for Martin Scorsese's The Irishman, I think he may come up empty on Sunday. It was a technical achievement of a film, and it was an epic gangster film, sort of him maybe sort of having his magnum opus on the genre of gangster movies. But it was a film that didn't really resonate emotionally with a lot of voters, and these voters vote with their emotions. So as much as they appreciated and respected what he did with the film, I don't think it's going to walk away with any prizes.
All right. You guys know that Jacqueline Coley is a Rotten Tomatoes editor. She's giving you the inside scoop. Okay, Jacqueline, I'm wrapping up. I want your personal best film favorite to win.
Whoa, that's like two questions. So personally, I think Bong Joon-ho's Parasite, which is 99% certified fresh on our tomato meter, is the best film of the year, might be the best film of the decade. However, I think the safe money is to bet on 1917, Sam Mendes' continuous one-shot World War II epic.
I always love an expert, and you're an expert, Jacqueline. Thank you for being my guest, and we'll be watching the Oscars. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television, and this is My Phone Pouch. My Phone Pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com. Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I have used Credit Help USA, the credit restoration company that's bonded and state certified. When you become a client of Credit Help USA, you become eligible for a set of stainless steel cookware from Credit Help USA and the Valder Beebe Show. Get your credit straight today. Visit CreditHelpTX.com, click on the Valder Beebe Show icon, and get started living life divinely.